Hello, Gavin, Hoey here with another Photoshop tutorial. This week, we're going to be turning our pictures into a jigsaw puzzle, and we're only going to use what Photoshop gives us as standard. So let's close that down and go back to our start image. Here we go. So this is the image we're going to use, but before we get going with our jigsaw puzzle, we need to do a bit of preparation. So go up to the layers, and you'll notice you have a single background layer. Well, we want two, so let's drag that down and make a copy of that layer. But we only want one of these to have the picture on. So I'm going to click the one at the bottom, the background layer, the one with the padlock on it. And I'm going to make sure I've got white as my foreground color. And then I'm going to go to edit and fill with foreground color like so. So I've now filled the lower layer with white and that's floating above the image itself. Now, why did I do that? Well, it's a bit difficult to explain now. All will become clear towards the very end of this tutorial. But let's just say that's quite important. Okay, so let's put this jigsaw puzzle effect together. Now, you could use the filter texturizer from the menu, but texturizer tends to work well with smaller sized images. This image has come off a digital SLR camera. It's got quite a high pixel count, and the old texturizer just can't cut it. So we're going to go and add a texture in, but doing it manually. So let's go find it. It's going to be under File and Open. Now you need to be in your Photoshop folder. Then when you're in there, look for the presets folder. Then you need to find the textures folder. And inside of there is a whole bunch of textures. Now these all come with Photoshop. I've been using, well, this technique for many years and many versions of Photoshop. And this particular texture has always been in there. The puzzle PSD texture. So that's one we're going to open. And we're going to add that to our image by getting the Move tool and just dragging it and dropping it on like so. Now you can see how much smaller the texture puzzle is compared to the original picture. So we need to stretch this out. Now on the texturizer, if you went via the filter route, you can only make it twice this size. That's still pretty tiny. But now we have it on the image, we have it as its own layer. We can do pretty much anything we want to it. So let's stretch this out using free transform. I'm just going to grab one of the corner handles and just drag this down like so, so it fills the screen. Now that's fine, but these jigsaw puzzles are pretty tiny, and I'd like my jigsaw puzzle pieces to be a little bit bigger. I'm not very good at jigsaw puzzles, so a 1,000-piece puzzle would keep me going forever. I'm more of your 20-piece puzzle man myself, so let's just zoom out a little bit so we can see. Now, you'll notice that this puzzle is looking really bad. Don't worry, it will look better, but as we're resizing it, it looks particularly poor. Okay, let's just move this down a little bit like that. Okay, lovely. What I'm trying to do is to make sure these edges pretty much come to the edge so we have full-size pieces on the edge of our image. When you're happy, click the tick or double-click inside, and now you have your puzzle effect stretched over your image. Now, where is the image? Well, it's still there. Don't panic. We haven't lost it at all. But we need to do a bit of work on this layer here just to make sure that it looks really like a jigsaw puzzle. Because at the moment, we've got these little sort of bits coming in around the edges. Now, those wouldn't be there on a proper jigsaw puzzle. So let's remove those. Make sure we have white as our foreground color still, which we do. And we're going to swap tools. We're going to use the pencil tool, not the paintbrush, the pencil tool. And using the pencil tool, we can neatly just take those areas away by drawing white onto them. Paintbrush tool is a much softer edge, and you run the risk of it bleeding onto bits you didn't want it to. Pencil tool is a very sharp tool, much easier to control, and for this job, it's absolutely the perfect tool to use. So around we go, taking those bits out, and that one there. And now you can see that all of the bits at the edge of the jigsaw puzzle have a nice straight edge to them. So what we need to do now is to get rid of some of this colour because the white is in the way. So we're going to cut the white out of the picture by using Select and using Colour Range. Now, if you've still got white as your foreground colour, then this should work just fine. If you haven't, just click on a white area of your picture and that'll make it the selected or sampled colour. Now you can move the fuzziness slider around, and as you see, our little preview gets thicker or thinner edges. Because we've resampled this puzzle texture up so much, it's got a little bit soft at the edges. So I'm going to push the fuzziness right the way to the right hand side, 200, and click OK. Then just going to come up or down to the keyboard and hit the delete key to get rid of those white areas and select and deselect. Okay, so our jigsaw puzzle effect is starting to come together, but it's not looking that real. At the moment, it looks like some black lines drawn over a picture. So we need to give this a bit of a 3D look. And we're going to do that by using layers, and specifically we're going to use this little F or FX icon to add a layer style. So let's click on the F or FX and choose bevel and emboss. Now we want to be using an inner bevel, and we want to be keeping the size is the key one. We don't want the size to go too high. Go too high and it affects the look quite badly. So you want this down in single figures. The depth, well, you can put more depth in for a more obvious look or less. And the softness will soften the whole look down as well. So you can balance the depth and the softness to achieve the look you're after. And it's a personal thing. I'm going to move the angle around a little bit as well, because I like it coming from the top sort of left corner, really. It's, again, a personal decision. Okay, so there's our jigsaw puzzle effect. It just looks a little bit harsh, a little bit black. And if yours is looking the same, here's the trick. Get the fill and just drop this fill down a little bit. Okay, let's go in nice and close so we can have a closer look. Now, when you take the fill down, you'll take what's inside of the image away, but leave the layer style behind. If you use the opacity, you'd take not only the image, but the layer style down equally. Now, you can go all the way down to the bottom if you like. I'm going to leave a little bit in there, just have a sort of 20% or so of the image coming through, so we have a bit of shadowing. That looks, for me, pretty good. Okay, so there's our basic effect completed. But to really finish this off, we're going to make this unfinished. We're going to take one piece out of the puzzle. So let's make sure we're working on the puzzle layer. We are indeed. And we'll go in nice and close. Well, let's take this centerpiece. It has to be the one in the middle, doesn't it? So we're going to cut this out using the magic wand tool and just clicking in the middle of the piece like that. Now you'll notice that the edge of our selection tends to miss the edge of our puzzle piece. So we're going to add a little bit more in, holding the shift key and just clicking just off the edge of the current selection so it expands it. Now, if you go too far, you're going to end up making a bit of a mess. So Control and Z just to keep it within the area there. That's actually pretty good. I'm still not 100% happy, so we're going to refine this edge a little bit more using Select. You can use Refine Edge. I prefer Modify. We're going to expand it just by 2 pixels, and then we're going to come back and select Modify and smooth it off, just to take off any rough edges by 5 pixels, like that. Okay, so working now on the actual image, not the puzzle texture, we're going to cut that out, edit and cut. And now you can see the importance of having that white background in the very first step that we did, because when we cut a hole in this picture, we get to see a white background. Now, we can also make this look a little bit more three-dimensional by adding a layer style to this as well. So let's go back to the layer style, and we're going to add in a drop shadow in there too. Okay, now I'll move this down so we can sort of see it, and you can just see that we can add a drop shadow in like that. Maybe just change the angle a little bit. That's it, come back. There we go. There we go. So that adds in just an extra three-dimensional effect that we couldn't have done if we didn't have this white background in behind. Okay, so we've cut our jigsaw puzzle piece out. We better put it back in again. Edit and paste. Now that's in the right place, of course, so we're going to get the move tool and we'll drag it over here. But you'll notice that the puzzle effect is going through the piece we pasted in. Now that's all down to the layers, because it's on the layer directly below the puzzle texture, so it's appearing over the top. Simply drag those two layers into the reverse order, like that, and now it floats above the texture. Okay, so all we need to do is just finish off that puzzle piece that's floating. I'm going to get this little FX here, I'm going to hold the Alt key on the keyboard or the Option key on a Mac, and drag that FX up to copy it to this layer. I'm going to double click the FX and put a similar drop shadow in as well. So let's click drop shadow like that. So that gives it, again, a three-dimensional look. It has a bit of depth to it. And finally, we're going to go to Edit and Free Transform. And we'll just spin this around a little bit so it's not in exactly the right alignment, and just drag it down there. Okay, so there you go. There's our jigsaw puzzle completed.